Okay. Good morning, all. Am I audible? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir.
Okay. Yes, okay, sir. Good. Okay. Thank you all. So in the last class, I have shared two class notes in the Google Classroom. Hope all of you have seen it. In the last few slides, I have given some problems with solutions. So have you seen all the problems? Then if you have any kind of doubts, then you could ask me. Otherwise, I'll start the second chapter. So in the first chapter, we have discussed the basic properties of complex valued function, then limit, continuity, differentiability, analytic function, harmonic function, how to evaluate harmonic conjugate. And after that, there are few applications of analytic functions with the help of problems I have discussed in the class note. So in the last class, how many of you have seen the notes which I have shared in the Google Classroom? Is there anyone who have gone through the notes? No one. So then what is the why I provide so much of effort in giving the PPTs and notes in the Google Classroom? So that all of you can see, I have given this in the last week because.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, do you have any doubts?
No, sir. It was clear.
Okay. Okay. So today I'll start a new chapter. So let me share my screen. Okay, so before I start new chapter, this is the geometric properties of complex valued function. That means you know that whenever we have discussed function of one variable, you know that by function of one variable, we actually geometrically represent the equation of a curve, locus of a curve. That means y equals to fx, the function of one variable. If we consider the independent variable separately, so corresponding to each and every independent variable, I'll get the value of the dependent variable y. Then together we can put the relationship in the form of a point in the two-dimensional space, then if I join those points, I'll be getting the locus of a curve. So this curve can be a straight line, this curve can be ellipse, this curve can be a circle. Similarly, if I consider the function of two variables, z equals to fxy, then there are total three variables. So if I vary the value of independent variable along xy plane, the corresponding to that I can draw the perpendicular along the z direction. Then if I join all those points, I'll be getting the locus of a surface. This surface can be surface of sphere, surface of ellipsoid, surface of three-dimensional plane, all these things. Similarly, for a function of complex variable, whenever I have discussed the first chapter, I have told that while we are dealing with the function of complex variable, in that case, there are four variables, w equals to fz. So w and z, both being the dependent variable and independent variable, will consider some values. So we'll consider the value of the independent variable z, by virtue of which I'll be getting the value of the dependent variable w. But here there is a problem. Since w and both z, both are complex numbers, so each and every complex number must have two parts. One is real part, and another is the imaginary component. So total, z has two parts and w has two parts. So how many total variables are here? So total four variables are here. So you know that we can draw a geometrical figure, or we can visualize a geometrical figure for three dimensions. So beyond three dimensions, we can't.
Yes, sir, but u is also a function of x and y. So how can, like, there are four variables, but two are dependent?
Yeah, total four variables. So u, whenever we are considering z equals to fxy, so total there are three variables. So z is dependent on x and y. So z is dependent, but z is only one variable, no? Whenever we are considering function of two variables.
Yes, sir, I know.
So similarly here, w equals to fz. So w is dependent on z. Again, w has two parts, u and v. So how many variables are here? U is a real value, v is a real value. Similarly in z, x is a real value, y is a real value. And together they are giving the complex number whenever we are adjoining them in the form of x plus iui or u plus iv. So u and v obviously will be dependent on x and y, because u, v, both are the dependent variables. So dependent variables will be dependent on the independent variable z. Here w, u and v, or w, is not dependent only on z, rather w is dependent on both x and y. Again, w has two parts, u and v. So obviously the dependent variable, since it has two parts, so it will be obviously dependent on two independent variables, x and y.
So in finally there are only two variables, x and y, because with x and y we can find u and v.
By x and y we can find v, but how many variables? Whenever you are dealing with the function of one variable, y equals to fs, how many total variables are there?
Sir, in y is equals to fx, only one variable, x.
One independent variable, but dependent variable one, so total two variables.
Okay, sir, talking about taking same, then it will.
Yeah, obviously, because whenever we are drawing the graph, so we can provide the relationship between independent and dependent variable. So independent variable we can choose arbitrarily, but dependent variable is also a variable that depends on the independent variable. But this is not a constant term, this is a variable. Because if I vary the value of independent variable, the dependent variable will also be changed. Is that clear or not?
Yes, sir, yes.
That's why dependent variable is not a constant term. Rather, dependent variable is also also a variable. But since it is depending on the value of the independent variable, that's why it is called as a dependent variable. But it is merely not a constant value. This is a variable. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So here, fz since equals to w, so w equals to u plus iv, z equals to x plus iy. So you can write down.
Sorry to interrupt you.
Yeah.
Sir, can you speak a little bit slow, because you are going very fast. We cannot understand.
Okay. Yeah. Obviously, if you face any kind of problem at any time, you can say.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Okay. So I am telling that. Okay. Let me discuss it. Here first, even note. There is even note. Okay, so this thing I'm telling because already I have told this while I have discussed in the first chapter. So geometrically, while you're considering the function of one variable, say y equals to fx, then what does it mean? There are two variables, x is the independent variable and y is the dependent variable. So total there are two variables. So this is also a variable, this is also a variable. But these we can choose independently. That's why it is called as the independent variable. And y is also a variable. But y we can not choose independently. Rather, whenever we are varying the value of x, the value of y will be changed. So total, there are two variables. So since there are two variables, so we can incorporate them in a two-dimensional geometrical figure, x, y. So we are taking x arbitrarily. For that, we are getting the value of y. So this indicates a point in a two-dimensional plane. So since there are two variables, so two variables can be represented as a two-dimensional plane. So if I join them, then it will give us the locus of a curve. So in general, this will be a curve. I have told this in the first chapter. Similarly, whenever we are considering a function of two variables, z equals to fxy, then number of independent variables are two, the dependent variable is one. So independent variable we can consider as a point in the two-dimensional plane, because it's a two-dimensional variable, x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y2. Then we can draw perpendicular in the z direction. So this is a point x1, y1, z1. This is a point x2, y2, z2, x3, y3, z3, and so on. So if I join this, it will be giving us the locus of a surface. So in general, this will represent a surface. But in the case of function of complex variable, since w equals to fz, so independent variable is z, but it has two parts, x and y. Similarly, this is a dependent variable w. So it has two parts, u and v. So total, there are four variables. So we can write in the form uv, f of xy. So how many total variables are there? Four variables are there. Is that clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we can't incorporate all the four variables in a single frame of reference, because we can only visualize a three-dimensional geometrical figure or two-dimensional geometrical figure. So in the first chapter also, while I have discussed, I have told that we can represent this geometrically like that. So we are taking a z-argon plane. We are taking a w-argon plane. So in z-argon plane, xy is the plane. X is the real part, y is the imaginary part. In the w-argon plane, u is the real part and v is the imaginary part. So we are taking a point, say, let's say we are taking w equals to fz equals to, say, w, that is equals to z square. So here we can write that u comma v equals to x square minus y square comma 2xy. So in that way. So here, if I take the point, say, 1, 0, and what will be the image by virtue of that function? So 1, 0 will be mapped to 1, 0. So x is 1, y is 0. So this will be 1, 0. So this is mapped to here. If I take here, say, 1, 1, then 1, 1 will be mapped to 0, 2. So this is mapped to 0, 2. Similarly, if I take here, say, 3, 0. So 3, 0 means here this will be 9, 0. So like that. So since there are four variables, so what we are doing here? We are taking a z-argon plane and w-argon plane separately. Then we are taking the value of the independent variable z as a two-dimensional point in the z-argon plane. So by virtue of that function, each and every point will be mapped to some points in the w-argon plane. So if I join these points, which we are taking as the independent variable, this will be a two-dimensional curve. Similarly, if I join their corresponding images, this will be a two-dimensional curve. So here, geometrically, we can assume that the function is rather here mapping a two-dimensional geometrical figure from one two-dimensional plane to another two-dimensional plane. So here, like the previous cases, we are not getting only one geometrical object, two-dimensional or three-dimensional geometrical object like the previous two cases. Rather, here we can consider the function as a transformation of a two-dimensional geometrical figure from one plane to another plane. Is that clear?
Sir, but we can join in any way the UV plane.
Anywhere in the UV plane means?
Like 1, 0, then 0, 2, then 9, 0.
Yeah, yeah. I am just giving a simple example here. So here, this curve fitting will be more accurate if we consider more independent variables. They are more closer. That means it will be accurate. This curve can be this sort of curve also. I don't know what is the exact curve. Just I am giving roughly. Okay.
Sir, should it be like a function that should it follow the rules of function, or it can be any curve?
It will be follow the rule of function, but here, like the function of one variable, it will not be a not be independent curve. This curve is independent because here we are taking x, we are getting the value of y, we are joining that. But here, this curve is not independent. This curve is dependent on this curve. This curve is independent. Is that clear or not?
No.
So what is the function? This function is actually z square. This function is z square. So what is the values here? Z is a value. So z means x plus iy. So here we can take only the values. x I y arbitrarily. Is that clear?
Yeah.
So corresponding to that, under this function, I'll be getting some points. So here, the curve that we are getting is not independent curve. This curve is dependent on the points which we are taking in the jet plane.
Oh.
Is that clear?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Then let's get back to this PPT. So here we can consider this. So that means one point. So without considering the curve, actually, in the more in the much easier concept, we can consider here that it is converting one point from z argon plane to w argon plane. Then if we take another value of z, it will be considering that plane, that point to that plane. So initially we can consider that one point independently we are considering in the z argon plane, then the function is mapping actually that point to some another point in another plane. This is not this z plane we are considering the z argon plane. So by virtue of this function, this is mapped to some other points in the w argon plane. So point is actually transformed to another point in different two dimensional plane. So we are considering here two dimensional plane. One is the independent plane, another is the dependent plane, and the function is actually mapping the independent values, or actually rather the points which are independently we are considering the z argon plane to some dependent points on the w argon plane. Is that clear?
Sir, there will be z instead of x on in the left one.
Why instead of x? Z though. This is a two dimensional point.
Sir, in the equation x is equals to x plus iy.
Oh, sorry, sir. It will be z. Sorry. Yeah. Sorry. By mistake it has been written. It will be z actually. Okay. Is that clear?
Yes sir.
Then here we'll be considering two different kind of mapping. So some of you have asked the question that whether the curve will be independent or not. So there are different patterns of curve, because while we are taking the independent variable z here, so the way we are taking here the values of z, so corresponding to that values only, we'll be getting some points in the w. So here if I take first 1 0, then 2 0, then 3 0, then 3 1, then 4 2, then corresponding all those points by virtue of that function, I'll be getting some points in the w plane. So if I consider the point in the different order or different sequence, then corresponding to those points, I'll be considering or I'll be getting different points in the w argon plane. So the independent variables z, the way we will consider the corresponding to which I'll be getting the values of the dependent variable. Okay, so depending on which, there are two kinds of a curve. So here independently we are taking the values of z. If I join those values, I'll be getting a specific curve. So if I join their corresponding images here in the w plane, I'll be getting another specific two dimensional curve. So I could imagine that the independent variable, the way we have considered, so that is actually forming a two dimensional curve, and this curve is actually mapped to some other two dimensional curve in the w argon plane. Okay, so depending on the pattern of independent variable we are considering, we'll be getting different sort of curves. So that is actually considered by these two kind of mapping. So mapping means, you know, that the drawing a graph, that is called a mapping. So there are two kind of mapping. Another is called a conformal mapping, another is called the isogonal mapping. What is the conformal mapping? Let's say we are considering the independent variable z in such a manner that it is giving us the locus of a curve, let's say c1. Then we are considering some other independent variables, that means the independent variables in other manner, in such a way that we are getting another C2 curve, because independent variable will be infinite, because z is a two dimensional point. So two dimensional number of two dimensional point will be infinite, you know. So we can consider some specific points at a time. Then if it gives the equation of, because you know that in a two dimensional curve or two dimensional plane, we can draw circle, we can draw straight line, we can draw ellipse. So a lot of different curves we can draw. So let's say we are considering the independent variable in such a way that it is giving us the curve, locus of the curve C1. In another way, we are considering the independent variable in such a way that it is giving us a curve C2. Let's say this C1 and C2 curve are intersecting each other at the given point x0, y0. Okay. So you know that since C1, the points which are over C1 is the independent variable. Similarly, the points which are over C2, they are also independent variables. So if I define a complex valued function, it will map each and every point on C1 to some points in the W plane. Similarly, each and every point on C2 will be mapped to some points in the W plane by virtue of a defined function. So let's say the point C1 is mapped to some points so that they are forming the curve C1 prime. Similarly, the independent variable which we have considered over C2 curve is mapped by virtue of the function fz in such a way that this is forming another curve C2 prime, and they are also intersecting at the point u0 comma v0. So this u0 comma v0 will be obviously the image of this x0 comma y0 which we are considering in the z argon plane or xy plane. So this two, so the mapping or the function, the complex valued function by with respect to which these two curves will be mapped to these two curves, if the angle that they are making here and the angle that they are making the W plane are same in magnitude, that means this value is 30 degree, this value is also 30 degree, then this is called as the isogonal mapping. The direction can be different. That means we are taking, because we know that we can measure the direction of the angle in two ways. If I want to measure this along clockwise direction, or we can measure the angle along anti-clockwise direction. So if the angle that they are making in the Z plane and the angle that their images are making in the W plane are same in magnitude as well as in direction, then the function or mapping W equals to FZ by virtue of which it is preserved is called as the conformal mapping. And if the mapping is only preserving the magnitude of the angle, but the direction is getting changed, so it is called as the isogonal mapping. Okay. Is that clear?
Sir, so XY plane is acting like a domain and UV plane
exactly
is like a range.
So here, without considering a single straight line as the independent variable, here we are considering actually one plane as the independent plane. That is the independent plane and that is the dependent plane. So here the z-argon plane, or rather XY plane, is acting as the domain and this UV plane acting as the codomain.
Considering this mapping, this is the conformal mapping, right? Because
this is the conformal mapping. The magnitude is looking same and the angle direction is also same. Direction is anti-clockwise direction here. Here also the direction is anti-clockwise.
So what if for x1, y1, there is no u1, v1, like it is undefined?
Then this whenever we are defining the function, these two points must be eliminated from this function, because for the function of one variable also. So for example, whenever we are defining, that's why we have studied the limit continuity differentiability, because in the case of function of one variable, it happens whenever we are taking the function fx equals to x square minus 4 by x minus 2, then at x equals to, the function is not defined. So either we need to take the limiting value, and if the limiting value exists, we can draw the function. Otherwise, from domain, we need to neglect that point. Is that clear? Similarly, here also, if for certain point x0, y0, if uv is not defined, then we need to either exclude that point from the domain, or we need to check the existence of limiting values at that given point. If the limiting value exists, we can consider that point. Otherwise, we need to exclude that point from the domain. Is that clear?
Yeah.
Then I'm giving the example of one isogonal mapping. So this is a very simple example. All of you have studied this. If I consider that each and every point here is mapped to its complex conjugate, that means complex conjugate, you know, whenever we are taking a point in the argon plane Z, then if I consider its image with respect to the real axis, then I'll be getting its conjugate. So fz equals to z var, that means each and every point in the argon plane Z is mapped to its corresponding complex conjugate. Then this mapping example of isogonal mapping. Why? Because let's say this is the z point. So here, let's say this is xy plane, and let's say this is uv plane. That the positive x axis is u and the negative y axis is v plane. So that is xy plane and that is say uv plane. So here z we have considered here. So z bar means the image of this point with respect to the real axis. So this will be z bar. So here z we are measuring along anti-clockwise direction, and z bar we are measuring along clockwise direction. So that's why here this magnitude of the angle, because the image of z is z bar. So the distance of z from this axis, x axis, is same as distance from z bar from x axis. But the angle which we are measuring to measure z in the anti-clockwise direction, and the angle which we are considering to measure the value of z bar, is along clockwise direction. But the magnitude of the angles are same. So this is an example of isogonal mapping. Is that clear? The mapping example of isogonal mapping?
Yes, sir.
No, sir. Can you say it again?
Okay. Just let me share one more screen. Yeah. Can you see the blank screen?
Yes.
So fz equals to z bar. That means what we are doing here, f of x comma y is mapped to x comma minus y, because z is x plus iy and z bar is x minus iy. Is that clear or not?
Yes, sir.
So that is our u, that is our v. So what is happening here? So let's say we take the two planes separately. There is the xy plane and that is the uv plane. So uv plane we can consider here as x axis and minus y axis. Is that clear or not? Because x is mapped to x, y is mapped to minus y. So v axis we can consider as minus y axis. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So here, instead of taking two different axes or two different frame of reference separately, we can consider this simultaneously. This is our v axis and this is x axis as well as this is u axis. Is that clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if I take here a point, let's say this is the point 1, 1. What will be its image? That will be 1 minus 1. This one. Similarly, if we take different points and join them by a curve, then this angle is made. So distance of 1, 1 from the origin and distance of minus 1, 1 from the origin will be same. So this angle will be same. But while we are going to measure the value of z, we need to go anti-clockwise direction. And whenever we are going to measure the value of z bar, we need to go the clockwise direction. So this angle are same, but this will be negative. So this is example of conformal map, isogonal mapping, because the angle is same in magnitude, but different in direction. Is that clear or not? Have you got it?
Yes, sir.
Can you also show that conformal one, that sine z into z?
Yeah, if you consider sine z.
No, it was sine z into z, or z not equals to n.
No, let's say fz equals to sine z. Okay, otherwise you can take fz equals to e to the power z.
Sir, I'm having trouble understanding what is C1 and C2 in the above example.
Here?
Yes, sir.
Here C1 means, actually I have given the example of one point. Okay, C1, C2 means, let's say this is x-axis, y-axis. Let's say this is uv-axis. C1, C2 means, here we are taking, say, let's say, collection of points. Let's say we are taking this as one C1, that is y equals to x car. So here we are taking what type of point? 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, like that. Is that clear or not? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes.
So we are taking the value of z in that way. That means we are taking only the values of z as 1, 1, because independent variable are infinite, so we can take independent variable as per our choice. Then let's say we are taking y equals to 2x. 2x means this sort of curve.
Sir, here we can take C2 as any point where x is something and y is equals to 0, then it would be more easy.
Yeah, you can take this also, this x-axis also. This is another curve. This is also the independent variable, because z means any sort of independent variables, okay? So if you take y equals to x and this is say y equals to 0. So these are two straight lines or two curves in z plane. Okay. Is that clear or not?
Yes, yes.
So in this case, we are taking the independent variable as 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, 0, like that. And in that case, we are taking the independent variable as z. So now if I consider the mapping fz equals to z bar. So where this map points will be mapped, this 1, 1, 2, 2 will be mapped to 1 minus 1, 2 minus 2, like that. Y equals to minus x. Is that clear or not?
Yes, yes, sir.
And this axis 1, 0 will be mapped to 1, 0, 2, 0 will be mapped to 2, 0, like that.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. So
if you measure this angle, let's say this angle is theta. So this angle will also be theta, but minus theta. So this is our curve C1. This is, let's say, curve C2. So this is our curve C1 prime. This is C2 prime. Is that clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Now we got it.
Yes.
Okay. So by C1 and C2 means while we are considering the independent variable in the z-argon plane, we can take the independent points arbitrarily. So let's say we are taking a set of points that is forming
sir,
a
graph C1. Can you take y is equals to 2x square, let's say x square, then there will be no angle will not be same.
Why you will not get angle? How you can measure the angle between two curves if it is not straight line? How you can measure
tangent?
The tangent? Yeah, obviously by tangent. So let's say this is y equals to x, and this is say y equals to x square. Measure this curve. So what is the angle? This is the angle. So this will be the angle. So here also, if you draw y equals to x will be mapped here, and this will be mapped to this. So this is the angle. Is that clear or not?
Yes, sir. I'm asking about that. If we take one y is equals to x and another c2 is equals to y is equals to x square, then
yeah, I have taken this too. Y equals to x square too. This yes, is the y equals to x square.
Then it will not be iso. That I forgot the name.
Why it will not be isogonal? This is isogonal though, because we are measuring the angle between these to this. If I measure the angle from x to this, then this angle will be from this angle to this angle, because this will be mapped to this. And this will be mapped to this. So we need to measure from this to this. Because if I measure the angle from this parabola to this straight line, the direction will be this. Then here, the direction will be this.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Is that clear or not?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Because whenever we are measuring the angle from parabola to straight line, here also we need to follow this. The image of this from image of this to image of this.
Yes.
Is that clear?
Yes.
Similarly, if you consider say y equals to e to the power z, e to the power z means e to the power x plus iy. Actually, this is not a simple example. Let us take simple example. Say y equals, because here if you want to draw the curve, e to the power x value, it is the value of e to the power y, is not very much easier for us to draw it manually. Rather, we need to calculate it through calculator. So I'm taking a simple curve, say y equals to z square. So z square means
it was sine z. Can you show that one?
Yeah, here also, if I consider sine z manually, it is not possible for us to draw the point. If you draw the point, it will be easier for you to show. Say y equals to sine z. So manually, how we can show that? Actually, because if you take the value of z, say z, you can take the value like this axis and say this x axis. You are taking this x axis, you are taking this. That means points you are considering as 1, 0, 2, 0, like that, and the point as 1, 1, 2, 1, like that. Sorry, 2, 2, like that. But here, if I know the point of 1, 2, then sine of x plus iy. So it is not very much easier for us to calculate from here. Okay, we need to separate this. I mean, sine x, cos iy, like that. Okay.
So, but in exams, you will come in front
yeah,
of
then I'll questions. Then there is a theorem through which we can check. Okay. Whenever you need to show whether this is isogonal mapping or conformal mapping, since okay. Isogonal mapping, the example is very easier and we can show it manually. That's why I have shown. But if you are asked to show it in exam, then there are different theorems through which you can prove that. Because if you are asked to check whether some function is analytic function or not, so you cannot check it manually. That for infinite number of points, the function is differentiable. So in that case, whenever you are assuming that or you are considering that, you need to show it by different rules or different theorems. Say here also, there are theorems to check whether a given function is conformal or not. But if you want to check it manually, then you need to check some easier function so that you can draw the graphs very easily.
Yes, sir. Got your point.
So you can take this y equals to z square, that y square minus x square.
Also, how can you calculate it's sine of complex number, like sine of I, Y, sine of 2I, sine of 3I.
That can be calculated by this formula. E to the power j, sine z means e to the power j.
Taylor expansion.
Yeah, by Taylor expansion or by this formation. Minus e to the power minus z by 2I.
Sine hyperbolic.
Not hyperbolic, sine z. Okay. What is sine x? Sine x is this, and sine hyperbolic x is, sorry, e to the power I z. Yeah. Right. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Otherwise, by Taylor series also, you can expand this and you can separate the real and imaginary part. Because here, if you consider this, z minus z cube by 3 factorial plus z to the power 5 by 5 factorial, you need to put the value of z equals to x plus iy, you need to separate the real and imaginary part. Okay.
Yes, sir, got it.
So these are not very much easier to draw manually by different programs through MATLAB or Mathematica. You can draw without programming by manual calculation. It is not possible for you to draw this kind of graph. Okay. Was that clear?
Yes.
Okay. So it's already 11:12. So let me take the attendance, and in the next class we'll be discussing how to check whether a given arbitrary function is conformal mapping or not. And we'll be discussing different sort of geometrical characteristics or properties of complex valued functions also.
So just a small query, sir. Yeah. For revision of the first chapter, can you suggest any like YouTube videos or something, because it requires some revision right now?
I've given the class notes too. I've given 3 class notes.
No, except the class notes, if some we require to understand more deeply, can you suggest any YouTube playlist or some another NPTEL, something like that?
YouTube video of myself or some other NPTEL?
If it is of your videos, then it is also fine, or if someone else, then it is also fine.
So your video, I'm providing the YouTube link of my channel. You can lots of recorded videos are there. You can see this. Otherwise, for NPTEL, you need to register actually.
Not
specifically. In NPTEL, there are actually free videos on YouTube.
Yes,
you actually have to pay for certificate only.
Yeah, no, I'm not telling that. I'm telling that if you want to revise that, so everything, say in IIT Kharagpur, if you follow some complex analysis notes, so everything is not discussed here, because I have completed only one chapter. So if you want to get the lecture notes on that chapter, so it is not like that in IIT also, this kind of syllabus is followed. Okay, so there,
yes,
whatever
syllabus is different, I have seen.
Yeah, that's why if you go through the video lectures, you'll not be able to understand directly. Whenever you are watching that for the first time, okay.
Sir, in your playlist, the we will get the same syllabus as I am, right?
Yeah, I'm so giving. Otherwise,
please share the channeling in the classroom or something like that.
Sir, please share in the WhatsApp group, sir. The link.
The WhatsApp group or classroom, anyone.
The WhatsApp group, I'm giving here. Okay, you can see.
Are there IMGRP codes for this class?
Yeah, I'll be giving. Wait. So simultaneously, yeah. So class recordings are also there. You can see if you wish.
Sir, did you put it in the chat?
No, I'm giving in the chat.
Okay.
Just wait. Okay, in the meanwhile, let me provide you the IMCRP code so that you just give the test, and I'll be taking the, I'm just searching and giving you this. So these are the codes, and this is the link. Just click the link and provide your full enrollment number and code. And meanwhile, I'm searching the YouTube link and giving. I'm going to go to the next one. In the chat box, I have given the YouTube channel link. Okay. So pre-recorded videos are also there, as well as some class recordings which I've taken so far in different streams, your CSBSAIML and electrical and other stream that are also there. And in the meanwhile, if I get some videos of IIT professors or any good videos which will cover the portions which I have discussed in your class, I'll be sharing in the Google Classroom or in the class.
Sir, in the IMCRP test, there are no scores. Like I, it is 0 by 0 in the IMCRP test.
Which one?
Is IMCRP test, it is showing 0 by 0.
0 by 0?
Yes,
sir.
Yes, sir. It is showing to everyone, CSBS AML students, all of you.
Yes, sir.
Yes, let me check once. I've given it. So apart from this channel link which I have provided, you can see this video also for analytic function. So this video is delivered by a professor of IIT Madras. So you can see this also. I can see that all of you have attempted this from different IP address. So exam I can see from search engine. The exam codes are same actually, 202101, 6920 for CSBS and 6921 for AIML. Can you try once more? Well, from here I can see your IP addresses also that you have signed in on 1118. 1118 AM, 1117, 1122 AM. Can anyone now check and see?
So I submitted the paper. Should I do it again?
Sir, we have submitted, sir.
Yeah, so some of you have submitted, though. So who are facing problem? Just I think.
Sir, it's not problem, sir. We are not given marks. It's 0 by 0 marks. So you have not given points to the questions.
I've not given points. Okay. So finish the test. Later on, I'll be checking it.
Sir, once submitted, there will not necessary to submit it again, right?
If you have once submitted, then you don't need to check it. But since you are saying that there is some problem, that's why those who are facing problems, for them, I am telling that you can submit it again. Otherwise, already if you have submitted, then you don't need to submit it again.
Submitted. The problem was regarding marks, that the question marks were not given. So
I'm checking. Okay, this is not a problem. Later on, I'll be checking it and doing. Okay. Okay, so thank you all for attending today's class. I'm leaving. Have a nice.
Sir, attendance, manual attendance.
Oh, I didn't take, na? Okay. Just wait. Yes, we are. Okay, AML rule number 1.
Present, sir.
2. 3.
Present, sir.
4. 5. 6.
Yes, sir.
7.
Present, sir.
8. 9.
Present, sir.
10. 11.
Yes, sir.
11 present, sir. Present, sir.
12. 13?
13 present, 13.
14?
Present, sir.
15?
Sir, 15 present.
16? Yeah. 17?
Present, 18?
Sir. 18? 19? 20? 21? 22?
Present, sir.
23? 24?
Present, sir.
25?
Present, sir.
26?
Present, sir.
27? 28?
Yes, sir.
29? 30? 31?
Present, sir.
32?
Present, sir.
33?
Present, sir.
34?
Present, sir.
35?
Yes, sir.
36?
Present, sir.
37?
Present, sir.
38?
Present, sir.
39?
Present, sir.
40?
Present, sir.
41?
Present, sir.
42? 43? 44?
Present, sir.
45? 46? 47? 48? 49?
50? Present, sir.
49?
Yes, sir.
50?
Present, sir.
51?
Present, sir. He has written in the chat box.
52? So while I'm taking attendance manually, I can see the chat box actually. So you need to respond, maybe unmuting yourself. 52? CSB is rule number 1. 2?
Present,
3.
Sir. Present, sir. 3 present.
4? Present, sir.
5?
Present, sir.
6?
Present, sir.
7?
Present, sir.
8? 9?
Present, sir.
10?
Present, sir.
11?
Present, sir. 11.
12?
12 present, sir. 12
13?
Present, sir.
14?
Present, sir.
15?
Present, sir.
16?
Present, sir.
17?
Present, sir.
18?
18 present, sir.
19? 20?
Present, sir.
21?
Present, sir.
23?
Present, sir.
24?
Present, sir.
25?
Present, sir.
26? 27?
Present, sir.
30?
Present, sir.
31?
Yes, sir.
32?
Present, sir.
33? 32.
Present, sir.
34?
Present, sir.
35?
Present, sir.
36? 37?
Present, sir.
38?
Present, sir.
39?
Present, sir.
40?
Present, sir.
41?
Present, sir.
42?
Yes, sir.
43? 44?
Yes, 45. Sir.
45?
Present, sir. 45.
46?
Present, sir.
47? 48?
Present, sir.
49? 50?
Present, sir.
51. 52.
Present, sir. 52.
Okay, thank you all for attending today's class. Have a nice day. I'm leaving.